Welcome to DC Motors videos. This is part 12. Here we will be seeing the electric braking in DC shunt motors. हम देखना है electric braking क्या है, वो DC shunt motors में क्या कैसे काम करता है. और आपको स्वागत है ये part 12 video में DC motors का. गाड़ी चलाने के समय आप ब्रेक दबाता है और ये ड्रम ब्रेक काम करता है इसे, ये क्या. सो ये कैसे करता है, इसको क्या बताता है, इसका नाम है क्या, ये कैसे काम करता है. ये ब्रेक दबाता है उसी समय ये ड्रम ब्रेक कुछ काम करता है, उसके बाद ये गाड़ी रुकता है, है क्या. सो इनसाइड द ड्रम ब्रेक यू विल बी एबल टू सी इट इज मूविंग सम ड्रम्स टू द मूविंग पार्ट्स. सो इट इज गिविंग सम फ्रिक्शन. So this type of brakes are known as mechanical brakes or friction brakes. ये friction apply करके brake करता है, like in our cycles, motorcycles, wherever due to the friction it is stopping the rotation. It is known as friction braking. Let us see, a motor we need to brought it to rest, stop करना है, रुकना है motor को. What are the methods available for that? There are two methods available. One is friction braking, as if you have just seen previously. अभी जो देख लिया friction braking वो भी है और electric braking भी है. तो friction brake तो क्या है, पहले देख लिया slide में, और electric brake का एक तरह और भी है. इसमें क्या फ़र्क है देखेंगे. ये mechanical brake has drawback. क्या क्या drawback है. mechanical braking गाड़ी में generally use करता है, उसमें कुछ drawback है देखेंगे हम. वो अच्छा smooth नहीं होगा, सडन स्टॉप भी हो सकता है, वेरी स्लो स्टॉप भी हो सकता है, वो यूनिफॉर्म ब्रेकिंग नहीं मिलेगा. उसको बताता है नॉन स्मूथ स्टॉप, नॉट अ यूनिफॉर्म वन. इट इज हैविंग डिफरेंसेस इन द स्टॉपिंग मेथ, सो इट इज नॉट स्मूथ स्टॉप. और डिपेंड ऑन द कंडीशन ऑफ ब्रेकिंग सर्विस. अभी नया गाड़ी है तो आसान से स्टॉप कर सकता है, बहुत सारा नंबर ऑफ साल यूज़ कर दिया है तो उसका इफेक्टिव ब्रेकिंग कम होता है. सो जितना लाइफ हो गया है उसके अनुसार कंडीशन खराब हो सकता है, फ्रिक्शन ब्रेकिंग भी खराब हो सकता है और पुअर हो सकता है. सो इट इज़ द ब्रेकिंग सरफेस का कंडीशन. थर्ड, इट इज़ स्किल ऑफ ऑपरेटर. सोचो एक ड्राइवर अच्छा तरह स्मूथ पक्का स्मूथ तरह स्टॉप कर सकता है, और एक बंदा इतना अच्छा ड्राइवर नहीं है तो वो सडन रुक करेगा तो प्रॉब्लम है ना. तो इट इज़ डिपेंडिंग ऑन द स्किल ऑफ द ऑपरेटर. हु इज़ द ऑपरेटिंग पर्सन टू अप्लाई द ब्रेक, डिपेंड ऑन हिज एक्सपीरियंस एंड स्किल ओनली गुड ब्रेकिंग विल बी हैपनिंग. सो दिस आर द प्रॉब्लम विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू मैकेनिकल ब्रेकिंग. नाउ विल बी सीइंग इलेक्ट्रिक ब्रेकिंग. इलेक्ट्रिक ब्रेकिंग एक्चुअली देर इज़ नो मैकेनिकल ब्रेक लाइनिंग सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग. सो मैकेनिकल गैजेट्स भी नहीं है. सो इट इज़ नॉट एट ऑल ए मैकेनिकली रिलेटेड आइटम डायरेक्टली. So we can say it is having life is very high. There is no tear and wear, so that is advantage, and it is efficient and smooth. So it we can smooth very smoothly. There is no sudden brake requirement. We can very smoothly stop and start, especially in railway application. You may be seeing in the metros and all. It is stopping very smoothly, so that you are not knowing even the movements. So it is should be smooth. So electric braking is happening there. And the additional requirement is आपके पास एक electric braking है तो भी वो stop किए तो कोई mechanical brake देना पड़ेगा वो उसी पर position में रुकने के लिए. Even if you are having electric brake and it is giving efficiency, smoothness, and there is no mechanical part, still we will be applying a mechanical स्टॉप. फाइनली एक बार रुक गया तो उसी पोजिशन में रुकने के लिए मैकेनिकल ब्रेकिंग सिस्टम चाहिए. सो इलेक्ट्रिक ब्रेकिंग स्टिल फाइनली करें स्मॉल मैकेनिकल ब्रेक. इफ़ यू आर अप्लाइंग द टोटल ब्रेक बाय मैकेनिकल इट विल बी वेरी बिग आइटम, बट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू इलेक्ट्रिकल ब्रेकिंग वी कैन हैव ए स्मॉल मैकेनिकल ब्रेकिंग सिस्टम. नाउ वी आर गोइंग फर्दर. एक्चुअली वी विल बी क्लासिफाइंग द इलेक्ट्रिक ब्रेकिंग. नाउ वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट shunt motor now and in the next video series what may be the condition. We'll be having three items. One is rheostatic or dynamic braking, first type rheostatic or dynamic braking, and after that plugging or reverse current braking and regenerative braking. So aapko ye yaad rakhna hai teenon naam, rheostatic or dynamic, plugging or reverse current and regenerative. We'll be explaining how ईच आइटम्स आर ऑपरेटिंग फर्स्ट इन डीसी शंट मोटर. हम डीसी शंट मोटर में इलेक्ट्रिक ब्रेकिंग कैसे काम करता है बताता है. पहले रियोस्टैटिक और डायनामिक ब्रेकिंग, उसके बाद प्लगिंग, उसके बाद रिजनरेटिव. देखेंगे एक एक करके. रियोस्टैटिक और डायनामिक ब्रेकिंग, पहला वाला रियोस्टैटिक और डायनामिक ब्रेकिंग. तो ये रहा हमारा ओरिजिनल डीसी मोटर का कंडीशन. शंट मोटर है, शंट फील्ड भी है, तो ओरिजिनल सप्लाई वोल्टेज आता है, करंट अंदर जाता है, आर्मेचर करंट रहेगा, शंट फील्ड करंट रहेगा और बैक ईएमएफ उसके ऑपोजिट रहेगा. और आर्मेचर करंट भी है, आर्मेचर रेजिस्टेंस भी है, या डायरेक्शन ऑफ रोटेशन मान सकता है. सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट हैज़ बीन मार्क्ड. सो दिस इज द ओरिजिनल डीसी मोटर. नाउ दिस इज द ओरिजिनल कंडीशन व्हेन इट इज नॉर्मली रोटेटिंग. टू स्टॉप दैट, अभी सोचो वी हैव टू स्टॉप और ब्रेक द रोटेशन. वाट वी कैन डू, फर्स्ट मेथड इज रियोस्टैटिक और डायनामिक ब्रेकिंग. इन दैट वाट यू आर गोइंग टू डू इज द आर्मेचर सर्क्यूट विल बी रिमूव्ड. दिस आर्मेचर सर्क्यूट विल बी रिमूव्ड बाई ए स्विच. सो द आर्मेचर सर्क्यूट विल बी एंटायरली सेपरेट एंड विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग सप्लाई टू द फील्ड. ये वोल्टेज अभी ऑफ नहीं करेगा और शंट फील्ड में अभी भी ये वोल्टेज मिलेगा. सो वट इज टू बी डन, विल बी जस्ट रिमूविंग द आर्मेचर फ्रॉम द मेन मोटर सर्क्यूट. दिस विल बी रिमूव्ड एंड द फील्ड विल बी स्टिल कनेक्टेड टू द सप्लाई वोल्टेज. देन वाट हैपन्स, लेट अस सी. सो दिस इज द पिक्चर वाट यू सीन. वाट आर द थिंग्स? आर्मेचर इज डिसकनेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सप्लाई, दैट इज फर्स्ट थिंग हैपन्ड. आर्मेचर इज डिसकनेक्टेड, देन कनेक्टेड अक्रॉस अ वेरिएबल रेसिस्टेंस. इधर आया है एक वेरिएबल रेसिस्टेंस है, ये आर्मेचर के टर्मिनल में कनेक्ट कर दिया है. तो एंटायरली ये सेपरेट सर्क्यूट बन गया है, सप्लाई वोल्टेज से कोई संबंध नहीं है डायरेक्टली. So this is a variable resistance is connected. So the procedure is to, you have to disconnect the armature and connect it to a separate variable resistance. And the field winding, it is still connected to the supply. Koi disturbance usme nahi hai. It is undisturbed. Ye method mein kya hota hai? Abhi kya hota hai? Ye motor tha, ये अभी भी चल रहा है. ये motor जो supply cut किया तो भी armature rotate करेगा, है क्या? You are not reaching to the final stop position. You are just disconnected. Still, the armature will be rotating. If the armature is rotating and this is the field, now what happens? This is becoming a generator action. This is becoming a generator. Supply field is available, armature is separate. So we can say this is becoming a generator sort of thing. Generator. Okay. If generator is available and generator is having load, a generator is having load, then depending on the load, it will be stopping, reducing the current. The maximum resistance, the lesser will be the current. It will be acting as a load to this generator. So this will be creating a braking effect. Already it has to generate, then only the current will flow. Now it is becoming a generator, it has to give out current. If high resistance is there, it is not able to. If the load current is more, that is, if you are reducing the resistance from high value to low value, the current will increase. So the current has to be given by the generator. If load is there, what happens? If there is no prime mover to this armature to open hai, koi support nahi hai, prime mover nahi hai. So there is no prime mover, then this will be coming to a stop slowly. So by varying the resistance from the maximum to minimum value, we are increasing the current, trying to increase the current that has to be given by this armature. But this becoming a load to the armature, finally this is becoming a braking to the armature, and there is a braking torque into the armature. So it will be opposing the armature rotation. So it will be slowly reducing the speed. As the speed is reducing, we can say the braking torque, TB means braking torque. Initially it is high speed, then it will be giving high braking torque. So yada braking torque milega. Lekin ye iska speed, when it is reducing, we can say the braking torque, because of the current, as current is reducing because of the low speed, reducing speed, current will reduce. Due to that, the braking torque also will be reduced. When the motor is coming to zero or standstill position, the braking torque also will become zero. The braking torque also will become zero. जब ये आर्मेचर रुकता है, उसका ब्रेकिंग टॉर्क भी स्टॉप होगा. सो दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ रियोस्टैटिक और डायनामिक ब्रेकिंग. वी विल बी गेटिंग गुड ब्रेकिंग, बट इट विल बी कमिंग टू जीरो पोजिशन. वेन देर इज नो करंट हियर, इट विल बी becoming zero braking. Effectively, no braking is there. So depending on the inertia and depending on the other conditions, it may rotate in some direction freely. So this is rheostatic or dynamic braking. The method is that armature will be disconnected and it is generator mode and it is loaded. And depending on the load and by operating the resistance, we can make into stop position. This is known as rheostatic or dynamic braking. Now we'll be seeing plugging or reverse current braking in DC shunt machine. Obviously, this is the again DC shunt machine. Now this is the plugging method. Plugging method, you can see the field is still connected. There is no change in the rheostatic method. It is similar to that. The field is still available, but this armature has been reconnected. Originally, armature was like this. Now it has been reconnected in this method. Okay. Now you may be remembering, if we change either field or armature, either field or armature, if we are changing, what happens? The direction of rotation will change. In a DC shunt motor or any DC motor, if we change the direction of armature current, then it will be having a direction of rotation in the opposite direction. Change in direction of rotation, that is available here now. Now, when we are changing the armature terminals, the problem is that the supply voltage and EB will be becoming in the same direction. Originally, V is available. This plus means the EB also will be plus. Effectively, it will be reducing. The effective circuit voltage will reduce normal operation. But if you are changing the armature terminals, EB and voltage will become in the same polarity and it may take heavy current through this circuit. So to reduce that, we have to give a additional resistance. So what is done in plugging or reverse current braking? The field current remains the same. There is no change. Only thing, you are changing the armature terminals. That direction of current through the armature originally like this, but after that changing, it will be like this. It is changed. Now what is the problem? It is directly changing the direction of rotation. Already motor is rotating in one direction. If we change the direction of rotation, means what? We are trying to break the motor. We are trying to break. Ek direction mein rotate karta hai. Hum breaking karta hai ka matlab hai opposite direction mein rotate karna try karta hai. To breaking badata hai. To electric braking shuru kar diya. Lekin EB ye voltage ke zamane mein same ho gaya. To zyada current aane ka chance hai. Humko zarur ek external resistance dalna hai. So we'll be putting a high value of resistance initially and its value will be reduced slowly. The resistance value will be high in the beginning. The operator has to reduce the resistance slowly. So what happens? It will be slowly changing the current and it is a smooth stop. We are not directly connecting to the supply. It is through the resistance with a reduction resistance slowly. So the advantage is it is giving us a very smooth stop. So this is happening in plug-in reverse current braking. The difference between rheostatic and plugging is that in the plugging, it is always connected to the supply. In the rheostatic braking, armature was separated. So this is the difference. Let us see. This is our picture. What is happening? Let us see. Armature terminals are reversed. Armature terminals, ab jab reverse kiya, the direction of rotation changes. Now, EB and V, in this condition, voltage and EB will be in the same direction. And what happens? It will be having a higher value of current. And to limit the armature current, we'll be putting a series resistance like this with a high value in the resistance beginning and slowly reducing the resistance. And this is the way we are doing plugging and reverse current braking. Let us say we are increasing the reducing the resistance and increasing the current. It will be braking torque will be there and it will be almost stopping the machine because the direction of rotation is changing. Originally it was having one direction of rotation and after that it will be trying to pull in the opposite direction, means it will be slowly reducing speed and coming to finally stop. Even the stop condition is reached, let us say the braking torque in plugging and reverse current braking, it will be there. That is a difference. In rheostatic or dynamic braking, the braking torque at zero, it is zero. At when the stop condition is there, it is zero. At rheostatic braking, the braking torque is zero at zero speed condition. But in the plugging, at zero speed condition, because the current is still available almost there, it is giving you a braking torque. So rheostatic, it is better than the rheostatic braking. and some power is drawn and the power will be dissipated. In the previous case, armature was separate in the rheostatic or dynamic braking, but in the plugging or reverse current braking, the resistance is always in the circuit. It is creating some loss and it is having some heat also. And as he told, the braking torque will be not zero. Some torque will be there after rotation is changing from one direction to other direction, and it will continue to rotate in the opposite direction if not disconnected. So this is the method. The difference is, in the original condition V is like this, and when plugging action is done, the back EMF it is adding to this condition. Now the third item for the DC shunt generator, it is a regenerative braking. Regenerative braking, let us see, this is the original condition again, and here you will be able to see the direction of current. In the original condition, the supply voltage is giving current inside. Here what happens, the current is going outside, and shunt field it is getting current in the both condition. So what is the difference? Here it is a motor condition, but in the right side it is a generator condition. Why it is becoming a generator? When the DC shunt motor under operation, when it is becoming generator automatically, then we are telling it as regenerative braking. Where it will be applied, let us say this is a DC motor and it is having a heavy load, like going downwards. This is a heavy load and this will be acting as a prime mover. You are giving already supply to this item and it will be having direction of rotation. Still, because of the load, it will be trying this to rotate more than the supply speed. Okay, so the load is driving this as a prime mover. So it is known as DC regenerative braking. So this type of load will be known as overrolling load. It is making as a prime mover and the machine is becoming a automatically a generator. And it is known as regeneration. So when EB is more, it is giving output current. Normally motors get input inside current to the inside, but when it is EB is becoming more than V, obviously voltage current will be going outside. This is known as regeneration. When regeneration is taking place, it is having a change in direction of rotation, and because of that it is giving a braking. So this is the regenerative braking. And if you are applying this automatically, if you are having a heavy load as the overrolling part, this automatically will be applying. But when it is almost stopped, when you are suddenly stopping the load movement, then mechanical brake may be required to hold this item. Why? Because when this is stopped, there is no prime mover action, and when there is no prime mover action, there is no regeneration. Then it is becoming motor again. So if you are switching off again also, we should be providing an additional mechanical brake for the regenerative braking. So these are the three types of braking in the DC shunt motor: rheostatic or dynamic braking, plugging, and third is regenerative braking. Thank you.